Hi, I'm Alfred Bundy. Welcome to the special edition of Meet the Leaders. We're here at the New Jersey Capitol in Trenton, New Jersey, talking to state legislators about what's going on here in Trenton today. Joining me now is State Senator Patrick.
Here goes.
Thank you so much. Listen, Senator, tell us a little bit about some of the concerns we're hearing about a possible federal shutdown. What would that mean to the state? Where you will be? What impact would that have on ours?
I just think it's sad what's going on in Washington, D.C., and I'm proud that that is not going on in New Jersey. You know, I respect the Republican side of the aisle, and the Republicans respect the Democratic side of the aisle. We work together. This business that if I don't get that my way, you know, if we don't get a wall to keep people out, I'm going to shut down the government. That's not what our founding fathers had in mind. Mm-hmm. I mean, one of my favorite expressions was Nelson Rockefeller. He used to say politics was the art of compromise. Now compromise is a dirty word. You know, if I don't get 100% of what I want, I demonize you and call you names, and not the way it's supposed to be.
Plus, the responsibility of all legislators, you think, is to create good government. Good government, wouldn't you say?
I think it's to try and improve the lives of others. I mean, we are blessed to be here. I mean, I was just talking before we came on. My father, both my parents were immigrants. My dad was a milkman. My mom was a maid. For me to stand here with you today, mispronouncing my name is something I never dreamed would happen. Right. And only in America. We got to remember that. Stop taking it for granted.
Let's talk about immigrants' rights. I mean, we have a problem that we're always concerned about, certainly taking care of our state and our rights here. But then how about the rights of immigrants? You know, there's been sanctuary cities set up in a few places in New Jersey. Where are you at on this issue?
I'm going to ask you a question. Between 1850 and 1910, guess how many Irish immigrated to the United States?
I'll never guess the number, but I'm sure it's high.
4.5 million. Did we survive? Did we prosper? I mean, we have 20 people coming across the border and they're tear gassing them. That's not what America's about. Obviously, we have to properly screen. We have to be certain that we're not letting in any terrorist groups or whatever, which I don't think any of these fall into. But let's, again, the Statue of Liberty is there to welcome people, not to push them away. It's really a sad epitaph that that's what we're doing.
You got children here who are part of the immigrants' families who are being sheltered. And some of them have not even been reconnected yet to their parents at all. A word about identification. Your thoughts?
Awful. In one word, awful. I mean, imagine separating a child from their parent. They're coming here with hope in their heart, leaving conditions that we can't even imagine, many times gang-related, violence-related, and they're dragging a child away from their parent. Again, not what our founding fathers had in mind.
We also are looking at a concern about the state being affordable, and some people who live here have been considering moving, and we've already had quite a bit of millennials who are now moving. What can we do to make the state more affordable? No taxes is a huge problem.
We are a vibrant state. I mean, we border New York City. I mean, supply and demand. I mean, one of my towns is Metuchen. It is absolutely booming with, you know, with millennials moving in and New Edison. It's a tough one. Obviously, we have to provide for reasonable, affordable housing, but economic conditions are, there's a reason people want to live here, and it's because of the upward mobility and the opportunity.
And close to New York City.
Close to New York City. I'm not moving to Montana anytime soon.
Okay. Certainly the fares are going up at New Jersey Transit, and coming both through Edison and parts of Metuchen is New Jersey Transit. What can we do to fix our problems? Because, you know, a lot of riders are concerned about New Jersey Transit.
Well, it's actually a good news story. In fact, today the governor is announcing that we're 100% in compliance with the federal mandate concerning positive traction control on the trains. We are also just purchased 113 new double-decker cars. We're doing 120 new buses. So, you know, for 8 years, New Jersey Transit was ignored, you know, without casting any stones. Governor and the commissioner and director had a tough job to do, and they're really stepping up to the plate. So I'm proud of them. I think they made a lot of advances.
So you think our governor, new governor Murphy's on the right track?
Absolutely. I think he's a great guy. I think he has his heart in the right place. He's progressive. He reflects New Jersey. I think he's doing a great job, and he's going to be a great governor.
I know there's a lot of issues, there's a lot of different bills and pieces of legislation that you have to look at, but tell me one that you're passionate about and you'd like to work with Governor Murphy when it gets passed.
Well, I'm chair of the Transportation Committee, so the whole plethora of bills concerning transportation, especially the communication part with those that use the service, I think is very, very important, because it's not an amenity. It's a need. It's the way you get to work. So to me, that's my top priority.
Okay. We are out of time, but we've been here in the State House talking to State Senator, and we're going to get this Patriot.
Okay.
Daigle?
No.
Daigle.
We was close.
We were close. We did well in the opening. Thank you so much for being with us on Meet the Leaders.